Hey guys, welcome to Malibu Art Collectors Club. You're here with Larissa and today we will talk about art advisors. Who are these people? Why do you need one? And how to choose one that suits your needs best. So I will try to demystify this interesting subject for you in this quick and helpful, hopefully, video. I've been working as an art advisor since 2006. I started in the United Arab Emirates and now working out of Los Angeles here in California. Who is an art advisor? I would like to think about an art advisor as a very helpful guide who is there to help you navigate the art world. If a collector is new, most probably you will need someone knowledgeable to help you out, and that's where a good art advisor is most helpful. Many art advisors have different backgrounds. Some of them come from, different art professions. Some have completely different mixture of skills. And I think, you know, the best idea to find someone that you understand well, you trust, you confident in, and a person who would have a certain set of skills. What skills are important for an art advisor to have? I will tell you a few that I consider really most important. Art advisor, as it is your guide, would have to have a very good network of people in the art world that he or she knows. So the art advisor would have good relationship with galleries, institutions, artists, worldwide or in the area where you're looking for in a specific country. Why is it important? Because an advisor would open the door for you, so to say, and make those introductions. So if an advisor comes in with a, you know, already established reputation, people know this person, people trust this person, so it's much easier to work with. And of course, it's even better if this art advisor is already your friend or someone who you trust or is referred by a trusted source. That's always very helpful. So I recommend that you get to know your art advisor before you start working a little bit, however possible it is, through friendship, through galleries, maybe ask for a feedback if someone knows this person. So what other skills are important in working with your art advisor? I think in my experience, it's very important to be honest in communication and tell your goals. What are you looking for as a collector? If you're a new collector, you might not know everything yet about yourself as you're just kind of going on this journey. So it's good to think about, what you would like to achieve, maybe in small steps. You can set a goal, for example, for the first year. I want to collect, let's say, acquire five wonderful works. Maybe you're starting with emerging artists, and then, you know, we will reassess. So a good advisor will be able to sit down with you and discuss all of those things, and you guys can look at different galleries, artists, what would make sense for you. Are you interested in figurative art? Are you interested in particular medium? Are you interested in some geographic region and would like to get to know the artist from that region better? Are you why are you collecting art? Is it something that really is your passion? Is it something that you're looking to add to your overall lifestyle as a hobby? So there are many different motivations that come and different for different people. So basically, once you set those goals, you will be in communication, hopefully constant communication, with your advisor on how to achieve them. So this is what I do with my clients. We talk, we go to galleries, we go to studio visits, we go to museums. You know, the more art you see together, the better it will be for you. What else is important? Important is to ask questions. Advisor can ask you questions and you can ask questions to your advisor. All sorts of questions. So it's basically education process. Look at it as a new degree. When you become a parent, you have to learn all about babies. When you go to college, you have to learn how to study there. So it's just one of those things. You have to put time to learn about yourself, who you are as an art collector, and to learn about the art world, find that little niche that you are trying to establish for yourself. So this is really an exciting journey, and I really enjoy my work when I work with my collectors. the benefit to the art advisor from this, other than this being a wonderful job, for me, most joyful experiences come from seeing how people change, they evolve, how they grow these new connections with the artists, the dialogues, how they start enjoying going to museums and galleries and art fairs. And it really becomes a huge plus in their life. I've seen people's life really benefit from it, their children love it. So far we discussed a couple skills for advisors. So those were including good communication skill, trust, information, and access to a worldwide network of professionals. Other things that are important to for advisor to have is this vision and knowledge to get to know the client and build with the client the collection that makes sense for the client. So don't fall for an advisor who kind of builds the same collection every time they work with the different clients. Of course, we're all humans and we'll have our favorite artists and maybe certain, you know, certain particular mediums that we like, but that doesn't mean that you have to collect the same things that your advisor likes. So a good advisor, that's very important to understand for a new collector, you know, will work with you, get to know really your taste, your motivation in the art world, and really tailor this journey for you. So you will be able to go to new galleries with advisor, to new museums, look at different examples of collections. I find it very useful when I work with my clients that look at different private collections, because that way it demonstrates different different approaches to collecting, what people, what art collectors were trying to achieve and how they went on that route. It's very insightful to see the journey of big collectors, big private collectors, and we have plenty of those collections in Los Angeles now. And it's really interesting because the journey starts from something usually small, one small acquisition that a person feels very passionate about, and then it becomes this huge transformation comes. And if they had good advisor, if they were assisted right, then the person is able to grow that little seed into something beautiful and something meaningful and really achieve something and contribute to the society. So we always have to remember, right, where does this passion lead? I mean, if you're one of those collectors like Eli Broad, who actually could give the collection back to the city, now we can all enjoy his museum and became an important part of a cultural landscape. So those examples are really interesting and I think motivating for young collectors, because we can see what can be achieved. So I hope this little review of art advisors and their role was helpful. So we just discussed a few different skills of them. And once again, to summarize, I think it should be someone who you know, you trust, you like, feel comfortable communicating with, someone with knowledge and a good network, great skills, whether communication or mostly communication and business skills, of course, that come to play. And someone with a vision, and a goal to get to know you and build for your collection that suits you and makes sense for you, okay? Thank you so much, guys. Please subscribe, like, and follow. I appreciate it. Say thank you and see you next time. Bye.